You already know the basics of OSPF, so we're not going to rehash that. Instead, we're going to look at how OSPF is configured on a Juniper device. Let's jump straight into some config. As shown here, I have a simple topology of two routers. One has already been configured, and we're going to configure the other one. The first simple step is to configure the interface with an IP address. We can test that it's good with a simple ping from one to the other. Dynamic routing protocols are configured under the protocols hierarchy. Under that, we have OSPF. We're just focusing on a simple neighbor relationship. That's done under the OSPF area, area 0 in our case. This includes interfaces that should participate in OSPF, virtual links, and other items. So, as you can see, we need to add our interface here to form a neighbor relationship. We can add many interfaces here, but we only need one for now. It's not a bad idea to set a router ID too. This is done for all routing protocols at once under the routing options hierarchy. It seems I'm forgetting where I am in the hierarchy. A simple show OSPF neighbor will confirm if this is working. We can see the IP and the interface that we're peering over, and the router ID of the peer. Of course, we can see the state is currently full. This is where we might see a state like 2-way, xstart, or any of the others. Show OSPF interface is another interesting one. With this, we can see the interfaces that OSPF is enabled on. We also see the router IDs of the DR and BDR, assuming that this is a broadcast network, of course. We can also see the number of neighbors on the interface. When we add an interface to OSPF config, we do two things. We begin advertising the network that's configured on the interface, and we start sending and accepting OSPF messages on that interface, which is the process that forms neighbors. That's the default behavior anyway. There are times when we only want to advertise the network, but we don't want the interface to participate in OSPF. For this, we need to configure the interface as a passive interface. To do this, we simply add the passive keyword when adding an interface to OSPF. This has been some pretty basic config, to be honest. If you're game, take a look at the lab in the members area. It's not for the faint-hearted though, it will challenge you. Things are going to get really interesting in the next video. We're looking at routing policies, which cover things like route filtering and route redistribution. If you're used to Cisco, you might find Juniper's approach a bit surprising. Click that video, and I'll see you there.